Hello, this is NanoDano at devdungeon.com. Do you want to learn how to make a Discord bot using Python? Then you're in the right place. In this video, we'll cover how to create a bot using Python for Discord. This bot will be able to join a server and show up in the user list. It will be able to interact in the chat rooms and private messages and respond to custom commands. Before we dig into the actual Python code, let's walk through the process of creating a server and a bot account for you to test with. This is the most complex part of the whole process, but you only have to do it once, and then you can use your bot forever after that, as long as you have the token. To create a new server, go to Discord. On the left side, where it shows you the list of servers, click on the plus sign to create a new server. It is free to create your own server. You can do this from the desktop application or the web interface. Now that you have a server, you'll need to create a bot. To create a bot, you need to first go to your Discord account developer portal at discordapp.com/developers. The links are all in the description. On the Discord developer page, go to the My Apps section on the left. On the My Apps page, click New App. Give the app a name. This is the name of the bot itself as it shows up in the username list. Add a description and an icon if you want to. You do not need to add a redirect for this example. That is only needed for more advanced features that we're not going to cover in this video. On the app creation page, it is worth noting that the Terms of Service link is available in the top right. If you have any questions about the rules, read those. Once the app has been created, you can review the information. Pay special attention to the client ID. You will need that later to authorize your bot to join your server. Now, scroll down to the section labeled Bot and create a bot user. This will allow your app to have an actual user that can join the servers and be interacted with. Once created, pay special attention to the token value. This is the important piece that you will need later. You can always get it again by visiting your apps page and looking at your bot detail page. In the Discord developer portal, go to the section labeled OAuth2 on the left side. On the OAuth2 page, look for the base authorization URL. That's the one we need. This is going to allow us to authorize the bot to join the new server that you created. You can copy the URL and then paste it into your browser. We will need to tweak it a little bit and add a little bit of information to the URL though. Get the client ID from your app, which we saw earlier. Modify the URL to append a question mark and then client_ID = your client ID. After that, you also need to append another parameter. Do this by adding an ampersand and scope = bot. In the end, it should look like this. When you visit this URL that you crafted, it should present you with a page that asks you which server you want to add the bot to. Choose the server and press authorize. You should see a green check mark and an authorized message. That's all the setup we need to do for now. The bot will then join the server, but it will appear offline for now since there's no code to run the engine for the bot. We can move on from here to actually looking at the Python code and building the actual bot, and you won't have to set up all this stuff again. All you'll need is the token value from your bot user. We're going to use one third-party module called discord.py. You can install this by running python-m pip install discord.py, or alternatively by running pip install discord.py. This is the module that abstracts away the Discord API and allows us to use it in Python. So here I am in Pycharm, a free IDE that I really like, and I've already created a blank file to start with named mybot.py. This is where we're going to put all of the logic for the bot. The discord.py library has some examples already, so let's start with those. go to github.com/wraps/discord.py. Again, these links are all in the description. Look inside the examples directory. Let's use reply.py as a starting place. Copy and paste the source code for reply.py and paste it into your Python script. Now, let's first review this code and see what it's doing. We're only using this as a starting place. The first line is simply importing the Discord module that we installed using pip. The next line is creating a new Discord client for us to use. Next, it looks like it creates a couple functions, one called onMessage and one called onReady. Both of them have a decorator labeled ClientEvent. I think it's safe to say that these are methods that are triggered on specific client events. Specifically, the onReady event happens when the bot starts up, and onMessage is triggered whenever a message is received. OnMessage received includes private messages, messages in chat channels. It even includes messages that the bot itself sends, so it includes every message that it sees on the server, or privately. The onReady function is a little simpler, so let's look at that one first. All it does is print out some client information. This confirms you are actually logged in, and lets you know that you're logged in as the right user and the connection was successfully established. The onMessage function starts with an if statement that checks whether the author of the message is the client itself. We want to ignore messages that the bot sends in order to prevent responding to our own messages. The next if statement checks to see if the message starts with a special string. If the message starts with that special string, it triggers the bot to react in a certain way. At the very bottom of the file, after all the function definitions, there is simply a call to client.run. The parameter says token as a string literal here, but we need to replace that with our bot's specific token that you obtained from the Discord developer portal. Plug in your token there and run the file just to test it out. When you run the file, you should see some text output confirming that you logged in properly, and then you can start chatting with your bot. Type !hello to see if your bot reacts. Perfect. Well, that's all there really is to it with the Python. You could do a lot with the bot just with the knowledge you have at this point. Before we go, I'll show you how to add another custom command to the bot. Go back to the source code to the onMessage function. Let's add another piece to the if statement. Add an elif statement and check to see if the string !bot is detected. We can reuse the existing code as a starting place. We'll check for the custom command and simply have the bot reply, "You rang." This is a contrived example, but it demonstrates an important concept. You can extend the bot with additional commands using this technique. This technique can get tedious, and it will look ugly if you have a large number of if statements. The Discord.py library does provide a more Pythonic way of doing it, but we'll look at that in another video. That's all for this video. Stay tuned for part 2, which will include some more meat and potatoes, and start making the bot do some fun things, and explore what is possible. You can have it react to other events, like a user joining the server, have it run background tasks that will periodically display a message. You can change the bot status to make it look like it's playing a game, and even have it interact with the voice chat. If you want to see a fully functional artificial intelligence chatbot, you can check out Chatty Cathy on the Dev Dungeon Projects page. Hop into the Dev Dungeon Discord server and try it out yourself. It's also completely open source, so you can run your own on your own server. The code is available at github.com/devdungeon/chattycathy, and all these links are in the description. If you want to learn more about AML, the AI chat system that powers Chatty Cathy, there is a separate tutorial on Dev Dungeon covering AML with Python. There is also another tutorial on Dev Dungeon about how to use Discord webhooks. The example there demonstrates how to check the Bitcoin price and post the message to a channel. Webhooks are slightly different than traditional bots and are generally less powerful and do only one-way communication. Thank you for watching. Check out devdungeon.com and please leave a comment if you have any questions or requests.